Hello dear students, myself Mr. Bhavesh Amurde, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry, KKV College of Pharmacy, Nasik. Today we are going to learn the determination of organic compound by qualitative analysis. So now, the definition of qualitative analysis. Qualitative chemical analysis is a branch of chemistry that deals with the identification of elements or grouping of elements present in our sample. More often, the sample is a complex mixture and a systemic analysis must be made in order that all the constituents may be identified. The analysis and identification of an unknown organic compounds constitutes a very important aspect of experimental organic chemistry. There is no definite set procedure that can be generally applied to organic qualitative analysis. Various books have different approaches, but a systemic approach based on the scheme given below with good result. The safety notes for these practicals. Assume that all the unknowns are inflammable and harmful by inhalation, ingestion and skin absorption. So do not inhale their vapors and avoid contact with eyes, skin and clothing. Now we can see the general scheme for analysis of organic compounds. First test is preliminary test. In that, the physical characteristics like solid, liquid or color and the order is observed. First is nature. If our compound is solid, then it is to be carboxylic acid, carbohydrate or the higher aromatic amines. If our compound is liquid, then it is to be alcohol, aldehydes, ketones, organic acid like acetic acid, esters or the ethers. After observation of the nature of the compound, we can observe the color of the compound. Most of nitrobenzene and the paranitroaniline are yellow in color. The colorless solids are carbohydrates and the organic acid. The colorless liquids are alcohol, aldehyde, ketone, simple ester, lower ether, aromatic hydrocarbons. The thiophenols and the thioalcohols are garlic-like order. The acetamide and the acetonitrile are rat-like order. The chloral and the chloral hydrate are cucumber-like order. The cinnamic acid are cinnamon-like order. Amines have fish-like order. The nitrobenzene and the nitrotoluenes are almond-like order. After performing the preliminary test, the first test is test for aromaticity, that is also known as the flame test. For performing the flame test, heat a small amount of our compound on a metal spatula or a copper foil to determine whether our compound is aliphatic or aromatic in nature. If we observe the luminous flame, then our compound is aliphatic in nature, or if we observe sooty flame, then our compound is aromatic. Test for solubility. First, we can take sample in a test tube, add 3 to 4 ml of water. If our compound is soluble, then we are moving towards the pH test. If our compound is insoluble, then we can perform take sample plus hydrochloric acid in a test tube. Second test is take sample plus NaOH in a test tube. Take sample plus N2CO3 in a test tube. If our compound is soluble in hydrochloric acid, then it may be base, or insoluble in hydrochloric acid, it may be acid. If our compound is soluble in NaOH solution, then it may be acid, or insoluble in NaOH solution, it may be base. If our compound observe the effervescence in Na2CO3 solution, then it may be strong acid, or if no effervescence observed, it may be weak acid. After performing the solubility test, if our compound is soluble in water, we are performing the litmus test. For the litmus test, take 0.1 gram of a substance, add 3 ml of water in a test tube. Shake well the solution Test the solution with a litmus paper. If our substance dissolves, then the lower member of alcohol, ester, ketone or the carbohydrates are present. If blue litmus paper turns red, then water soluble acid or phenol may be present. If red litmus turns blue, water soluble base present. If no action on the litmus paper, water soluble neutrals are present. Next test is test for aliphatic unsaturation. In that, first test is Bayer's test, another one is bromine water test and the reaction with bromine in chloroform test. Material required for these tests are potassium hydroxide solution, bromine water solution, carbon tetrachloride, chloroform, potassium permanganate solution, sample compound to be tested, distilled water, test tubes and test tube holders. First test is Bayer's test. In this test, the pink color of potassium permanganate disappears when an alkaline potassium permanganate is added to an unsaturated hydrocarbon. The disappearance of pink color may take place with or without the formation of brown precipitate of manganese oxide. If the decolorization of pink color of KMnO4 indicates the unsaturation. This is the graphical representation of Bayer's test. If our test is positive, then KMnO4 reacts implies the presence of a double bond MnO2 brown sludge is observed in a test tube. If our test is negative, then KMnO4 is not decolorized, implies that a double bond is not present in our compound. The another test is elemental analysis. It is also known as the sodium fusion test or Lassaigne's test. It is a general test for the detection of halogens, nitrogen and sulfur in an organic compound. The ionic compound formed during the fusion are extracted in an aqueous solution and can be detected by simple chemical tests. The extract is called as sodium fusion extract or the Lassaigne's extract. These are the reactions of sodium elemental analysis. So let us see the procedure for elemental analysis. Take a small piece of dry sodium metal in a fusion tube and heat it gently till the metal melts or fuses. Add equal quantity of compound to this fused metal. If the compound is liquid, then add 2 drops of the compound with a capillary. Heat it gently with the strongly till become red hot. Plunge the red hot tube in 10 ml, 3/4 position of the test tube of distilled water taken in a porcelain dish. Covering it immediately with an asbestos sheet, crush the fusion tube completely. Carry out more fusion in the similar way. Boil the extract for 5 minutes, reduce the volume to up to 5 ml and filter the perform following test using the filtrate. Test for nitrogen. For this test, take 1 ml of extract plus 2-3 drops of NaOH solution to make it alkaline. Add a few drops of freshly prepared FeSO4 solution, boil for a few minutes, cool and acidify with adding dilute HCl or the dilute H2SO4. If we observe blue or green color solution or preserved blue coloration, then nitrogen is present in our compound. Another test is test for sulfur. For this test, take 1 ml of extract, 1 ml 2 normal acetic acid plus 1 ml lead acetate solution. If the black precipitate is observed, sulfur is present in our compound. The another test is 1 ml of extract plus 1 drop of sodium nitroprusside solution. Violet or purple coloration is observed, then sulfur is present in our compound. The third test is 1 ml of extract plus 1 ml of aqueous epiCl3 solution. If the blood red coloration is observed, then the nitrogen and the sulfur are present in our compound. Third test is test for halogen. For this test, take 1 ml of extract plus 1 ml dilute HNO3, boil if the nitrogen and sulfur are present. 1 ml of extract, 1 ml of 5% HNO3 solution. If the thick white precipitate is observed, then the halogens are present in our compound. If the halogens are present, carry out the following test. Procedure for this test is 1 ml of extract plus 1 ml of dilute H2SO4 plus 0.5 ml of CHCl3 and 0.5 ml of chlorine water. Shake this solution and observe the layer of chloroform. If the violet layer is observed, then iodine is present. If the yellow or brown color layer is observed, then the bromine is present. If the colorless layer is observed, chlorine is present. The classification of the compounds are on the basis of elements present in our compound. There are four main groups. Group 1, that is the CHO, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. In that, carboxylic acids, phenols are the neutrals. In group 2, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen are the nitrogen. It means CHON. In that, carboxylic acids, phenols, bases are the neutrals. Group 3 means CHONS, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur. Acids are the neutrals. In group 4, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and halogens are present. Means the compound is neutral. Flame test. So here we can perform the flame test. The procedure for the flame test is, add a pinch of our some compound on a copper foil and heat on a burner. Here the flame is non-sooty, so our compound is aliphatic compound. Now we perform the test for saturation, that is also known as the KMNO4 test or the Baer's test. Here the procedure is, add a substance, in that add 2 ml of water, in that add 2 to 3 ml of water. Shake the solution. In that solution add 2 to 3 drops of KMNO4 solution. Here is no decolorization of KMNO4. So our compound is saturated. Now we can perform the solubility test. For the solubility test, 0.1 gram of our substance, add 3 ml of water, compound is soluble in water. So now we can perform the pH test to identify that in our compound water soluble, acid is present. So now we can check the litmus paper test. Add a drop of test solution on the red litmus paper. There is no change in color of red litmus paper have been seen. Now we can check on blue litmus paper. There is no change in blue to red. So both water soluble acid, phenol and the base are absent in our compound, means water soluble neutral is present in our compound. We can test one another test for solubility. If the substance is NaOH, gram of substance is added in test tube, add NaOH solution in that. Com-
compound is insoluble in NaOH, so neutral compound is present. For the element detection in our compound, we can perform the sodium fusion test. It is also known as the element detection test. The process for this: add a small piece of sodium metal in the fusion tube, heat on a burner until it becomes red. Add an equal amount of compound in the sodium fusion tube after heating. Now again heat the fusion tube after adding the compound. After heating, add the fusion tube in porcelain dish containing the water. So boil this sodium fusion extract for 5 minutes. After boiling for 5 minutes, filter this sodium fusion extract. For removing some impurities. After filtration, we can perform the detection of elements. First test is detection of nitrogen. For this test, we can take a test tube, add 1 ml of our sodium fusion extract, add 2 to 3 drops of NaOH solution. Shake this mixture. After that, we can add 2 to 3 drops of FeSO4 solution. So here is no change in color. So nitrogen is absent in our compound. Now the another test is test for sulfur. For this, add 1 ml of extract in a test tube. Add 2 normal acetic acid, 1 to 2 drops of heat this mixture for few minutes. After this, add 1 ml of lead acetate solution. Here is no white precipitate is seen, no white or black precipitate is seen, so sulfur is absent in our compound. Now we can perform the test for halogens. For this test, add 1 ml of sodium fusion extract. After this, add 1 ml of dilute HNO3 solution. So there is no white precipitate is seen. So halogens are absent in our compound. After finding all the detection of elements, we can observe that key no nitrogen, sulfur or the halogens are present in our compound. So our compound contains only CHO group, that is the group 1, which contains the carboxylic acid, phenols or the neutrals. After performing the detection of element test, we can now further study for the detection of functional group test for our CHO group. We can perform the test for functional group detection test for the carbohydrate group, that is the CHO neutral group, because our compound contains CHO neutral group. For this test, first we can test the test for carbohydrate, that is the Mollis test. For this, add 0.5 gram of our substance, add 2 ml of our water, this Mollis test is performed only for the compound if soluble in water. Add 2 to 3 drops of alpha naphthol. After the addition of 2 to 3 drops of 10% alpha naphthol solution, we can add 1 ml of concentrated H2SO4 solution. So here we can see the dark color layer appear. So carbohydrate is present in our compound. So now we can perform the test for aldehydes or ketones. For this, add 0.5 gram of our compound in a test tube. Add 3 ml of 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine solution. So here we can see the orange red crystalline precipitate. So aldehyde or ketone are present in our compound. Now we are moving towards the melting point determination. For melting point determination of solids, we can take first capillary. It can pull on the bottom. Now we can feel our compound in the capillary. Here is our compound. So now we are proceed for the next process. After filling the capillary, we are attached the capillary towards the thermometer, then continuously heating provided to the thiols tube.
Well plateized.
Here we can see our substance is melting, and the melting point of our substance is 138 to 140 degrees Celsius.
Synopsis. First question is, which compound get precipitate in the detection of carbon and hydrogen? Options are copper, carbon dioxide, calcium carbonate, and copper sulfate. The option is, the right answer is calcium carbonate. The calcium carbonate get precipitated in the detection of carbon and hydrogens. Second question is, identify the element that cannot be detected by Lassaigne's test. Options are nitrogen, fluorine, sulfur, and the phosphorus. The answer is fluorine. Fluorine cannot be detected by the Lassaigne's test. Third question is, what is Lassaigne's test extract is called as? Options are fusion extract, sodium fusion extract, Lassaigne's extract, and the sodium extract. The right answer is sodium fusion extract. Fourth question is, in the test for nitrogen, the sodium fusion extract is acidified with which of the following? Options are dilute sulfuric acid, dilute hydrochloric acid, concentrated hydrochloric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. The right answer is concentrated sulfuric acid. Concentrated sulfuric acid question is, what is the color of precipitate obtained in the test for sulfur? Options are white, black, violet or blue. The right answer is black. The black color of precipitate obtained in the test for sulfur.